Hello Internet, this is Oscar Lise again. For this video, I'll be going over how to use secant method to solve systems of nonlinear equations. I'll go over the background and history before visualizing how the method works and then providing some discussion. For context, you should have some familiarity with secant method. I recommend watching my award-winning video on this topic, as well as Newton's method for systems of nonlinear equations. Recall that with secant method, we're given two starting points, and we draw the secant line that travels between them. Where it crosses the x-axis, we create our next point. Then using our last two points, repeat the process and draw another secant to find our next point. And so on and so forth, until we reach an approximation close enough to our root. For the rest of this video, I'm going to keep referring back to the secant method for simultaneous nonlinear equations by Wolf. This method was also found by Wittner, published in German, covered in Convergence of Multipoint Iterative Methods by Tornheim. Let's look at secant method, but from a different angle. x3 we can write as the sum of 1 half of x1 plus 1 half of x2. x4 can be written as the sum of 1 fifth of x2 plus 4 fifths of x3. And x5 can be written as the sum of negative 4 21sts of x3 plus 25 21sts of x4. But where are these numbers coming from? To find those numbers, I have been solving this system each iteration. For example, 1 half of x1 plus a half of x2, given that a half of the function at x1 plus a half of the function x2 gives a sum of 0, and that a half plus a half gives us 1. The same is true of x4, that 1 fifth of the function at x2 plus 4 fifths of the function at x3 gives us 0, and 1 fifth plus 4 fifths is 1. To solve this, I'm using this linear system each iteration. Finally, the last step that we showed is also from that linear system. Both of these methods of using either secant method as we know it or solving a linear system are doing the same thing. We can rewrite our system like this. We can use this second method to solve systems of nonlinear equations. Here's a nonlinear example that we'll be using, as in my earlier videos on this topic, with these four solutions. Our first step is to rewrite our system in terms of zero, where our solutions all map to the origin. Let's take our first starting point at 1, 1, and because this is a secant method, we're going to need another point. For example, 1, 2. Plug this into our linear system, and this doesn't work. That's because for d dimensions, we're going to need d plus 1 points. Let's take a third point at the value 1.52, and now set up this linear system, which we can rewrite. We can use any linear system solver to solve this. Once we do, we'll get these values for p, which we can then plug in to our summation for our next value for x. Given this value for x4, when plugged into f, looks like that. Then we take our last three points, notice how we no longer need the value of 1, 1, and use this in our linear system. We solve the linear system like before, and use our new summation to give this value for x5. Plot it right there. We then repeat the process with the last three points until our distance between our steps becomes less than some epsilon the norm, or our function is close enough at that value, or reach the maximum number of iterations. Let's look at a numeric example. Here, we use an ending value of 10 to the minus 6 as our epsilon. From these three starting points, it only takes a few more iterations to actually converge on a solution. Notice we haven't used the Jacobian once. Let's talk about the all-important order. For secant method and nonlinear systems, it actually depends. In Tornheim's paper, he's able to prove that the order depends on this function, meaning the higher the dimensionality, the slower it converges. With 1, it converges 1.618, normal secant method. But as you increase dimensionality, the order slows down. This might surprise you, but the method I've discussed is not the only secant method. Richard Brent describes some efficient algorithms for solving systems of nonlinear equations, describing other secant methods. But he also doesn't compare this to the well-known Broyden's method. Brent also does not compare this version of secant method, citing those three papers from earlier, as well as this additional one by Barnes, is actually really good, noting that the math and the assumptions you have to make comparison difficult. And interestingly enough, he actually thanks Wolf for his suggestions in the acknowledgement. In summary, you can use secant method to solve systems of nonlinear equations giving you a superlinear order. The method should be credited to Wolf and Pittner, and there actually isn't a Jacobian. We also need to solve a linear system each iteration and start with d plus 1 starting points. There are other classes of quote-unquote secant method, but those deserve their own videos. You could also make fractals using this method, but I'll leave that as an exercise for the viewer. The code that I wrote will be hosted on GitHub. As always, thank you for watching. You all really seem to enjoy my earlier video on Newton's method for systems of nonlinear equations, and I hope you found this one interesting as well. Please continue to give me feedback on this series, and thank you so much for your support.